1-2, what is this? The 5 foot assassin with the roughneck business. I float like gravity, never had a cavity. Got more rhymes than the one that's got family. No need to sweat Arsenio to gain some type of fame. No shame in my game, cause I always be the same. Styles upon styles upon styles is what I have. You wanna just a fifer, but you still don't know the half. I sport New Balance sneakers to avoid a narrow path. Messing around with dust against the size of the... I never have stuff, cause I'm not a half stepper. Drink a lot of soda, so they call me Dr. Pepper. Refuse to compete with BS competition. Your name is specialist, so won't you suckle with the mission? I never walk the street, think it's all about
me. No matter where you're from, right? We are starting with the foundation of reggae music, and this is the way it should be. Carly!
Yeah, my name's Steve Hayles, I'm one of the founders of Upfest, the Urban Paint Festival, based here in Bedminster. Upfest was established in 2008, it was a gathering of artists to paint live in front of people. Sort of 10 years on, we now run Europe's largest street art and graffiti festival. The USP sort of being that people can actually come and watch the artwork sort of develop, as opposed to having to walk into a gallery space, etc., seeing finished work. About watching sort of the process predominantly around sort of street artists, but that's anything from kind of fine artists to contemporary artists who just happen to paint canvases on the street. Some people use graffiti as a term for everything. Street art is, I guess, is more of a modern phenomena, with the likes of kind of sort of Banksy and the kind of stencil artists sort of kicking that off sort of 10, 15 years ago. Whereas graffiti generally is talking about kind of the practice of sort of like letter writing, so writing your name, anything from kind of sort of like tagging through to kind of you know, big sort of lettering production pieces. In recent years, and kind of as time's gone on, the type of artist doing street art, you know, street art has become less of a genre and just more about the place. And sort of said that, you know, you get artists from all different walks of life. You know, we even get urban knitters come to the festival doing their knitting on the street. I think in the early years, so like 10, 15 years ago, when you had, you know, mainly sort of like the stencil artists, Nick Walker and that, those sort of street artists, you know, were very much sort of stencil based. You know, going back 30 years with the graffiti artists, you've got sort of 3D and sort of Robert and Niger sort of doing kind of, you know, sort of wild style sort of pieces. And that's kind of where the history sort of started 30 years ago, you know, brought over from kind of like New York. Generally that was done through sort of the publication of books like Subway Art and sort of kids and stuff in the UK, seeing all these sort of painted trains. And that kind of, yeah, it was the sort of the start of it over here. It's kind of just been a transition. You now have graffiti and street art almost sort of working parallel. So a commission, it's basically where you've got a property owner who has a space, who wants to enhance it with a piece of art. There's always been public art. It's just nowadays, especially in and around Bristol, you know, people understand the sort of value in getting a wall painted, you know, with an art piece as opposed to just painting it white or grey. I don't know the exact stats, but if you look at sort of visitors to the city, you know, one of the top five reasons for them coming to the city is the street art. So the economic impact for the city alone has been great. It does bring communities sort of like together if it's sort of done in the right way. I think kind of, you know, some people obviously have views on traditional graffiti and kind of like tagging and the way that can have a negative effect sort of like on an area. If you look at the area sort of like Bedminster we're in now, 10 years ago, there was no artwork around basically. There was the Dean Lane Skate Park, which had more traditional graffiti, but now people are moving to this area. And the locals loving the fact that they get to see artwork every day and don't have to pay to go into a museum to see it. Who's to say what is right and wrong as opposed to kind of like style? You know, some of the artists that do lettering pieces, you know, have gone on to be, you know, quite well known abstract painters. You know, and the likes of sort of Jago and a few others like that, they've taken that kind of sort of lettering form and moved it more into kind of a world of sort of contemporary sort of art. Yeah, it's definitely important to have both running alongside each other.